गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडेज टॉपिक इज मॉड्यूल नंबर 5, सीक्वेंसिंग मॉडल्स. सीक्वेंसिंग इज एन एलोकेशन टेक्निक इन विच m नंबर ऑफ जॉब्स आर टू बी प्रोसेस्ड ऑन n नंबर ऑफ मशीन्स इन द बेस्ट पॉसिबल सीक्वेंस सच दैट द टोटल कॉस्ट टाइम एसोसिएटेड विद इट इज मिनिमाइज्ड. सो इन सीक्वेंसिंग मॉडल्स बिफोर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम्स वी हैव टू डू सर्टेन अजम्पशंस. फर्स्ट वन इज ओनली वन ऑपरेशन इज कैरिड आउट ऑन ए मशीन एट एनी पर्टिकुलर टाइम. Second, each operation once started must be completed. Third one, one machine of each type is available. Fourth one, jobs are to be processed in a given order only. Fifth one, the transportation time between the machines is negligible. Sixth assumption, jobs are completely known and are ready for processing. Seventh assumption, the succeeding operation cannot be started before the previous jobs are completed. Full stop. Okay. Now in sequencing, there are three types of problems. The first one, n number of jobs, two machines. Means what? Number of jobs are many here, but machines are two. Second type is n jobs, three machines or four machines. Means here, number of jobs are many, machines may be three, four, etc. The third type of sequencing model is m machines, two jobs. It is a graphical method. So graphical method is applicable when only two jobs are there and many number of machines are there. So today we will be starting with the first one, n jobs, two machine problem. The algorithm that we are going to use in sequencing model is Johnson's algorithm or Johnson's rule of sequencing. So today's first method is n jobs, two machine problem. So I'll be solving a first numerical on method number one, n jobs, two machine problem. So the problem is written here. Seven jobs are to be processed on two machines A and B in the order AB. See here, order given is AB. Sometimes the order will be given as BA. So we have to see the order correctly. Processing times in hours is given. We have to find out what is the optimal sequence, what is the time required for processing all the jobs, and what is the idle time of machine A and B. So the given numerical is here. Seven jobs are given, 1 to 7. Two machines are given and all these are the processing times in hours for each job on each machine. For example, 3 is the processing time of job 1 on machine A. 8 hours is the processing time of job 1 on machine B. Like this, they have given the processing times. So the first step of Johnson's algorithm to find out the best sequence of processing is as follows. So first we have to draw a block consisting of 7 number of cells. 7 cells, why I have taken is that since jobs are 7, we have to draw 7 cells and show this block. Left side you have to write machine A, show an arrow pointing towards inside. Right side you have to write machine B, arrow pointing towards in. You should not forget this. Now, to start with the problem, to find out the optimal sequence, the first step is see what is the minimum processing time given for machine A and machine B. Check all the seven timings. Check all these timings. In all the timings, see which is the minimum processing time given. So minimum processing time given is 1 hour for job number 6. 1 hour for job number 6 under machine B. Correct? Under machine B. So 1 is the minimum processing time for job number 6 under machine B. So job number 6 we have to write under machine B in this block. B is on the right side. So first I will write job number 6 here. And then after writing job number 6, we delete this complete row by a dotted line. In bracket I have written 1, which indicates that this row is now deleted first. See the remaining processing times. We have to not consider this row now. Leaving this, see what are the minimum processing times here as well as here. The next minimum processing time is 3. It is here also, it is here also. You can take anyone. See here, whenever there is more than one minimum time, you can take randomly. It indicates there are more than one answer for such a numerical. I will take job here. 3 hours is the minimum processing time. It is for job 1 under machine A. Job 1 under A. So job 1 I have to write under A, this side. Job 1 I have written here. So after writing that, you have to delete this also. Two rows have gone. out of the remaining rows, see which is the next minimum time. The next minimum time is 3 for job 7 under B. 3 is the minimum processing time for job 7 under B. 7 I will write under B. Correct? Now I will delete this row also. Third one. Out of the remaining time, see which is the minimum time. The minimum time is, which is the minimum time here? Once again, it is 6 for job number 4. But this 6 is under B. So job 4 I have to write under B. B is here. So write job 4. After writing job 4 here, delete this job 4 also. What is the next minimum time? 12, 10, 15, 10, 10. So next is 10. So right, start from the top. So next processing time is, minimum is 10. This is for job 2 under B. Job 2 under B. So job 2 I will write under B from this side. And I will delete this also. Always start from the top. What is the next processing time? Minimum 10. It is for job number 3. 3 I have written here. Then I will delete. What is the last timing remaining? It is for job number 5. Job number 5 is 10 under A. From this side you write job 5. Like this you complete the table. Therefore the optimal sequence is 1, 5, 3, 2, 4, 7, 6. This is the optimal sequence. So first we have to take job 1, process on machine A, then on machine B it will be completed. Like this, then you take 5, 3, 2, 4, 7, 6. This is the optimal sequence of processing all the jobs in the optimum sequence. Now we have to find out what is the total time required for processing all the jobs. What is the total time required for processing all the jobs? For that we have to draw this table. We have to draw this table. What is this table? Write the job sequence. The optimal sequence that you obtained is 1, 5, 3, 2, 4, 7, 6. This sequence you have to write correctly. Then machine A, machine B. The order given in the question is order AB. So write first machine A, then machine B. Correct? For machine A, write time in, time out. For machine B, time in, time out. Draw the columns. Write the optimum sequence here. Now, time in, time out. What is time in? Processing time started. Time out means processing is over. Job 1's in time on machine A. See here, job 1 will first be processed on machine A. Then it will go on machine B. It will be completed. Then job 5 will come on machine A. Then on B it will be completed. Then job 3 will come. So first job 1 will be going on machine A. The time in is always 0. Time in is always 0. What is time out on machine A? What is the processing time of job 1? The processing time of job 1 on machine A. Processing time of job 1 on machine A is 3. Correct? So time out will be 0 plus 3. 0 plus 3 is 3. Means 3 hours is required for processing. So time out is 3. Correct? Next for job 5. As soon as job 1 is over at 3, this 3 will come here. So time in for job 5 will be 3. What is time out? See the processing time of job 5 for machine A only. Job 5, machine A, it is 10. 3 plus 10, 13. Correct? Next, this 13, as soon as job 5 is over at 13, next job will enter at 13. So for job 3, 13 is time in. What is time out? See the processing time of job 3 on machine A. Job 3 on machine A is 15. 13 plus 15 is 28. So 28 is the out time. So this 28 will be the in time for next job. In time for next job. So 28. So job 2. Correct? In time. What is the out time of job 2? Job 2 is processing time is 12 on machine A. So this 12. 28 plus 12, 40. So 40 will be in time for this next job number 4. Correct? For job 4. What is job 4? Time in is 40. What is time out? See the processing time of job 4 on machine A. It is 7. 47. So like this you continue till I get this number 67. So machine A, time in, time out is we have to. Now for machine B, what is the time in and time out? Job number 1, 0 is the time in, 3 is the time out on machine A. As soon as it is out, it will go on machine B. So this number 3 will be the time in for machine B. Correct? Time in. So what is time out? Check the processing time of job number 1 on machine B, on machine B. Job number 1 on machine B. See here. Job number 1 on machine B now. What is the time? 8. Correct? So this 8 I have to add. 3 plus 8 is 11. Time out. Job 1 is over. So as soon as machine B is free, means job 1 is out. See here. We have to take, initially you are taking this 3 here. But this 11 I am not writing here because next job, job number 5 is working up to 13. So by writing this 11 here, see the next job. Since it is working up to 13, processing up to 13, this 13 we have to write here. Means this number, next jobs out, this we have to compare. Whichever is greater we have to write here. So write here 13 for job 5. See the processing time of job 5 on machine B. 13 plus job 5's processing time is 12. 13 plus 12 is 25. Correct? This 25 I am not writing here because for next job 3 timeout is more, 28. So it is greater. So whichever is greater of these two I write here. So this I write here, 28. Time in is 28. What is the timeout? Job 3 machine B I have to see. Job 3 machine B is 10. So this 10, 28 plus 10, 38. Correct? So this 38 I am not writing here. Before writing this number here, I check the previous, this one. So 40 is greater, so I write here. So 40. Like this, you go on continuing till you get the last number. So this number 68 hours is the total processing time of all the jobs. 1, 5, 3, 2, 4, 7, 6. All these jobs in this optimum sequence only. First take job 1, then 5, 3, 2, 4, 7, 6. So this is the optimum sequence. In this sequence, total time required for processing all the jobs in this sequence is 68 hours. So this is the total time required for processing all the jobs. Total time required for processing all the jobs is 68 hours. Next, what they have told? They have told us to find out what is the idle time of machine A and machine B. What is the idle time of machine A and idle B? So to find out the idle time of machine A and machine B, we have to refer this table only. See here this table, machine A. So machine A started its work for job number 1 at 0. It processed up to 3. Next at 3, the next job came up to 13, it was processing. Immediately after 13, the next job came up to 28. Then from 28 to 40, 40 to 47, 47 to... So this number was continuously... So machine A was continuously busy from 0 to 3, 3 to 13, like this up to 67. In between, there was no gap. So 67 minutes machine A was working. What is the total time of processing? Total time of processing, all these jobs were 68. But for 67 hours, machine A was working. Therefore, the idle time of machine A is only last 1 hour, 68 minus 67. Idle time of machine A is 1 hour, that is 68 minus 67. Correct? So always machine A is busy. So check this number with the total time. What is the idle time of machine B now? While finding out the idle time of machine B, always we have to see here because this machine is always idle at the starting. First job was under process for machine A. At that time, machine B was idle for 3 minutes at the starting. Machine B was idle at the starting. It started its work from 3 to 11. Then 13 to 25 it is processing, but 11 to 13 idle. Correct? Then 13 to 25 it is processing job 5. 28 to 38 it is processing job 3, but from 25 to 28, 3 hours idle. Like this 38 to 40, 2 hours idle. Here 50, 50 it is same. So in between it is idle. This number you have to check this number. If they are same, no idle time. But if they are different, idle time is there. So like this starting 3 hours, then this 2, this 3, we go on writing here. 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 8. Last is 68. So last it is working. So the total idle time of machine B is 18 hours. So in this manner we have to find out the idle time of machine A and machine B. Here we complete the problem. All of you, thank you.